Brachycephalic breeds are now some of the most popular pedigree breeds.
It's about their dogs. They can do that through the breed clubs, but in addition, we're about to set up an emailing from the Kennel Club to known owners of these dogs. And if you get such an email, then please help.
Hopefully, we can get rid of some of the more severely diseased dogs, and the whole population will get healthier.
I want to see those breeds have better health and have better quality of life.
How important
is it? No, but I mean the people.
Thank you. Has she? Okay, that's good. She's still there today, though, yeah?
That's fine. Well, we'll see how it unfolds.
Yes, I have. She's walking into our studio here, the goldfish bowl in Hall 3. Come along, Jutta, put these on your head. She's here now. She's so shiny, it's a testament that you're caring for her extremely well.
Yeah, just like that inside, yeah, she's a natural instinct, which is fantastic.
Okay, quite sweet.
She's okay. So much.
Alright, thanks a lot.
Yes.
Actually, it's a bit old hat because we brought this ruling in over a year ago, and all that's happened this time around is that the judge has actually said that she is going to follow the rulings, and of course she should, because she is the judge. She's expected to judge the breed standard, and that's what she's doing. But the reasoning behind it is that nobody in Shih Tzus or in the Kennel Club wants to see these dogs going around with big pink frilly bows in their hair. They are meant to be shown as naturally as possible. They're allowed to have a top knot, in other words, to have a rubber band or whatever to tie the hair up, simply to make sure that the dog can see properly when they're moving around the ring. And that should be it. It should be as plain as possible. And that's all that the judge did, was say, that's what I'll be doing, so please don't come with the pink frilly bows. They're certainly not allowed to use hairspray or colour or anything else in their dog's hair. So, no, we're pretty strict, actually. We do watch what's going on.
Oh, you've had a good day then.
Thank you. like I've that, don't they? Like Eric or Dennis
yeah, Eric,
or something.
Yeah. Eric's quite common. Isn't
yeah,
it?
We've had several Erics. They're called the Teds, Normans.
Yeah.
Well, we had a Joe, didn't we?
Yeah, Joe's kind of cool.
Yeah,
though.
We had Joe.
We got to Helen Sam still.
Yeah, we got Sam. Yeah, we got Sam. Yeah. Yeah, you can slow down now.
We've got to wait that away anyway.
We've got to wait anyway.
Oh, okay.
Oh, they're coming. They're coming, there's four of them.
Yeah. I need to finish the press release first.
Okay. Well, since they said there was only one, you must have heard about
it. Different department.
You've had 91 bikes on your picture.
I know.
A veteran is...
Well, it's all right when it's fine, but it's the Yvette Kelly. Yvette Kelly.
Yeah.
There was the Lowe sisters,
of course.
There was Jackie and Julie, obviously.
Of course,
yeah. Over-adorned, because really we're about making sure that dogs are seen as they really are rather than with pink ruffles in their hair. That's fine. As far as we're concerned, if people have a traditional way of showing dogs in their own country, then that's absolutely fine, they can do so. But the way that we show in the UK tends to be a little bit more plain, if you like. And so therefore we expect everybody to show on a level playing field and to do the same thing. What we haven't done is ban people from actually putting their dog's hair into a top knot, and I'm only talking about the Shih Tzu breed here. It's a breed that has very long, fine hair.
Got my license.
Thank you.
Oh,
right, okay.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right.
We'll try and do it that way, come and see what happens.
Thank you very much. You want that one of those so you don't lose one? Put the number on the van. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
We want to get to hole one.
Yes.
Tonight, you will have to be seated by 4:50, and the best way to get down there, in fact, is to go down the outside to the pavilion main doors. But please be there by 4:50, and you have to be seated throughout. We don't expect to finish much before 8 o'clock. But the important thing is, at 5:30, we have for the first time the final of the Ukanuba 10th anniversary. So if you can be there, I'd be grateful. Thank you.
Left. We were at the pavilion for the
catering
lunch place.
Right, thank you.
It's fine, thank you.
I'll just give him a ring now. He only wanted to see you personally, but you know he's the district manager there. Right.
Did you have a nice lunch?
I did, it was lovely. Yeah, thank you very much
for
that.
See
you.
Hello.
He said he was an hour before he went. So, and I wasn't sure where you are. I didn't want to miss it.
So much more going on, as you know, and this show, and I think that's really highlighted with the Scruffs competition, which is taking place in the main arena later on today, which is a really fantastic mix, isn't it, of crossbreed dogs, isn't it?
It is, and the whole point is that we want to make sure that all dogs are showcased. We are about all dogs, and that's very important when you think about
competition itself. Scruffs kicks off with heats around the country, doesn't it, at various events, around about the middle of the year, doesn't it, and broken down into various categories, again, arranged by yourselves, the Kennel Club. Judges today is Alex Gregory, who's a two-time Olympic gold medalist, rowing medalist, and the other judge is again someone more involved in the world of dog judging, isn't it? David Guy,
who is actually one of our board members.
I'm sure you join me in wishing them all the very best of luck later on in the main arena. Caroline Kisco, thank you very much indeed.
Thanks,
Caroline. We'll get there at the end of the day.
Television yesterday morning, Caroline.
That's painful.
No, but I mean, our judge didn't have much, did she?
No, she didn't. She didn't have to say it. It would have been better if she hadn't.
Well, if she was going to say it, she could have put a little preamble for the benefit of my lovely friends from the overseas.
Yes, exactly.
Anyway.
You know, she pulls me anywhere she wants to go.
She's such a sweetheart, though.
She is.
Yeah, I think you're very wise to have her up in the air. Yeah.
Thank you.
I was waiting by the desk.
She wants to look vulnerable.
Yes, that's a trouble.
Hello.
beginning of the evening programme, so they'll be taking their seats and everything now.
Thank you. We tried to miss the crowds, thanks. Oh, hang on. Caused you a havoc, haven't I? I'm sorry. That's all right, don't worry. Thank you very much. All the security again.
Thank you.
Good, yeah, it's fine.
But Ben and I put it back in the morning.
he's got
no,
Shirley hasn't drunk her prosecco, it's only
top. Oh, she said Melissa could have it, apparently.
Melissa has got a pretty full one already.
It's all going to voice now.
Really? Oh, David went over and was like, oh, it's a Sarah's bow. I didn't see
it. And apparently she had tears in her eyes and nearly lost it and had to pass it on her script because she couldn't, got so upset. And she's known to be more than that.